Hi, welcome to this episode of the Pie Blog. I'm glad you could make it. There's a lot to cover in this episode, so let's get started. On this week's episode of the Pie Blog, we're going to be taking a trip to the grocery store so that we can see our ingredients on the shelf. We're also going to be looking at stand mixers versus hand kneading for pizza dough, and we're going to get to the announcements for Pie in the Sky and the Pie Blog. First up is a trip to the grocery store to take a look at our ingredients and their natural environment. We're going to begin today on the oil aisle. Now this is corn oil, which as you can tell from this picture I don't use, but if you prefer to use this because of the cooking characteristics or the taste, go right ahead. However, I teach what I was taught, which is extra virgin olive oil. That means that it is cold pressed and unfiltered. No chemicals were ever used to obtain the oil. And here it is, what you're looking for, all-purpose flour. Now not everyone can eat this, so there are other varieties for special dietetic needs such as soy, gram, and rye. Our recipe calls for 1/4 ounce of yeast or 1 package, and these are those packages. Marked across the top clearly are the words active dry yeast. Now if you're going to be scaling this recipe up or down to meet your specific needs, what you should do is buy the yeast in a little bit of a larger amount in these jars. You can take out the exact amount you need with a dry measuring spoon. And that's our tutorial. I'm just going to hang around here surrounded by olive oil and chocolate after a long day. And there you have it, those are your 4 ingredients. Now let's move on to our next segment and take a look at my stand mixer while we discuss stand mixing versus hand kneading for pizza dough. Now as you can see here, my cobalt blue workhorse has got the 3 attachments that came with it on display. The whisk, the batter paddle, and the dough hook, which I've never used for pizza dough but is excellent for cookie dough. I just feel that for pizza dough, the dough hook gives it too much of an airy, fluffy texture, which usually results in more air bubbles in the finished product than I like. However, the perfect pizza is all about what you want to go with. And if that's what you're comfortable with, whip it out. On the other side of the coin, as I mentioned before, is hand kneading. Just as there are directions to use a dough hook attachment with your stand mixer, there is also a technique to be developed for hand kneading. The method I've developed over the years for hand kneading pizza dough is pretty simple. You just start out by smashing it back and forth between your fingers and then work it from hand to hand, folding it in and over on itself. Using a good smashing action is important. However, equally as important is not to overexert yourself and rush through the process. This can injure your forearm and result in a permanent injury, also known as tennis elbow or tendonitis. What you may start to notice after your first time hand kneading within a few hours is pain that goes from the tip of the thumb, across the wrist, and up the inside of the forearm to the elbow. This is normal muscle strain. However, if you start feeling pain within a few days across the top of the wrist, that goes across the top of your forearm, up to the elbow, this is definitely tendonitis and you need to see a doctor. And there you have it. So as you can see, this is definitely something that takes time and conditioning. Don't try to muscle it and you should be okay. But if you do find yourself with forearm strain afterwards, I would recommend that you start an exercise program emphasizing forearm muscle structure, or you should just switch to your stand mixer and avoid the whole thing altogether. Now, the time required to hand knead the pizza dough for my recipe's finished amount is 5 to 6 minutes. If you are using a stand mixer, go ahead and follow normal dough instructions. Just as long as all the dry ingredients are completely absorbed, you should be fine. And I get a little bit of extra satisfaction out of watching those I serve it to enjoy it, knowing that I put my own hands on it and created it from beginning to end. It just makes me feel good. Two announcements this week. First, the winners of the Brew to You contest. There were no winners. That's because nobody entered. According to the experts at YouTube headquarters, this contest was too difficult.
What?
So, I'm gonna start a new contest, a Halloween costume contest. There will be three categories of costumes. One will be the scariest costume, the second will be the friendliest costume, and the third will be the absolute laziest costume. All you have to do to enter is post a video response to any pie in the sky or the pie blog episode of you in your Halloween costume, and you're entered to win. That's all there is to it. Good luck. Okay, that's it for this week's episode of the Pie Blog. I'd like to thank everyone for watching and remind you to keep sending in those great questions and comments to the comments section of the Coldhitz channel. That's Coldhitz. Don't forget to tune in for this week's episode of Pie in the Sky, and keep practicing, because soon someone you love is going to ask you to make pizza tonight. Goodbye, everyone.
Just because we get around.
Talking about my generation.
Things they do look awful.
Talking about my generation.
I hope I die before I get old.
Talking about my generation.
Take my generation.